Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. Thank you all so much for being here. If you're here for the first time, I do want to say thank you, and I do want to ask you to just go ahead and subscribe. You won't be disappointed. You'll love the content, you'll enjoy the family, and we have lots of fun. Seriously, we do lives, or we're going to get back on our lives, and they're a ton of fun. You meet great people, you get great information. For those of you who are trying to go to school, thinking about going to school, not too sure, this is the place to find out about phlebotomy and see if it's something you may want to do full-time, part-time, be mobile, whatever the case may be. This is the spot. We talk about it all, and we are here to help. So make sure you subscribe, turn your notification bell on so you don't miss any uploads. Make sure you tweak that notification bell as well for those of you who are having trouble. I know a few weeks ago, months ago, a lot of you were like, I'm not getting the notification. If you're getting it, it's late. You know, the same thing happens to me. So it's technology. I don't understand it, but you know, we're going to get through this together. But just make sure you turn it on so that when I do go live, when I do upload, you guys will know, and you can just be in the loop and know what's going on. So I want to give a shout out to my new subscribers. Yes, lots of new subscribers. You guys are following me over on IG. I thank you guys so much for that. Snot Box is getting love, the Fleb Box is getting love, and thank you. I cannot say it enough, because I'm just glad that it came at the right time for you all, the Snot Box and the Fleb Box, and they're doing great. I love you guys for it. And make sure you go ahead and get what you want. I'm tweaking the Fleb Boxes as far as discontinuing one or two of them. I'm not sure. I'm checking my list to see what's selling, what's not selling. You know, it's not a problem to keep them on the list, but sometimes a $50 Fleb Box will jump out at me, and you know, I'm low on butterflies or something. You know, I'm waiting for my shipment to come in from my suppliers, supporters, or whomever, and you know, it can get kind of rocky. So that's happened in the past, but it's never an issue because I always make good. Never anyone's ordered anything and not gotten it. There's nothing like that. I just hate for you guys to have to wait. If I say it's coming within 3 to 4 days or add an extra two, I don't want it to be 10, 15 days before you get your box. So make sure you go ahead and get what you want. And if you have any questions or concerns, just email me, because I can always make provisions. It's all about the order draw today. Yes, because since I've been gone, taking a hiatus, and you guys will find out why very soon, within the next few months, I will let you guys in on some great news. A lot of great things are happening on a personal level and business level, so you guys are really gonna appreciate Chrisnastic being missing for a while. So yeah, the order of draw, get a lot of emails, again, DMs, text messages, you name it, about the order of draw. Now, the order of draw is one of those things where you can come up with a mnemonic on your own to help you memorize the order of draw. You know, there are order of draw songs, there are order of draw mnemonics out there, and just someone like myself, you know, came up with it. There's no right or wrong way to remember the order of draw. Whatever sticks, that's what you want to use. So for me, my personality, you guys know I'm out there like, hey, let's go get it, let's be good at this, let's relax, let's not take it so serious, and you know, just have fun with it, because that's one of the ways and one of the things that's going to make you a successful phlebotomist. I promise you that. It's your attitude more than anything else. No one wants a snooty, snotty, even quiet phlebotomist drawing their blood. No, customer service is talking and speaking to people, and it, you know, things going on right now, you know, we're not connecting with one another. So in healthcare, it's a must. Yes, you can't, these streets will beat you down, but when you go to work, if you're in healthcare, you gotta lighten things up. And it is part of your, it should be, I should say, because it's not in the handbook, or, you know, your, the handbook, the employee handbook, to say, oh, you know, do this, be extra nice to your patients. No, it's something you just have to know. And if you're in healthcare, you already know that. You're that type of person. So there's, the same thing goes with phlebotomists. And as for us, you know, we're coming in with needles, man. We're coming in with the artillery, pretty much. And not everyone wants to see us, you know? So we have to have a persona that relaxes our patient. So I say all that, What does it have to do with order or draw? Well, it has to do a lot with the mnemonic that I came up with for you to remember the order of draw. First of all, your tubes are blue, red, gold, green, lavender. Okay, that's first. Your blue, then your red, your gold, your green, and your lavender. Some people will say, oh, well, we draw the red first. That's okay. That's okay. Now, that would change my mnemonic. It would basically mean I have to say, ready, be. But hey, ready, be, baby. Let's just be ready, or ready, be. Okay? It depends on where you are. Now, the order of draw across the board is going to be the same. It's going to be blue, red, gold, green, lavender at your facility. Or they're going to say, oh, no, here we pull the red first. Okay, that's not wrong. That's what they do. Because I remember when we used to pull the reds first and then we pulled the blue. Well, what is it? Is it blue? Is it red? Okay, there's nothing in the red, so it's really not gonna affect your blue. That's why it's one of those things that's like, huh, what's first? Just follow procedures where you are. Policies and procedures at your facility. If they say draw the red first, draw the red first. If they say pull the blue first, pull the blue first. If you don't feel comfortable pulling your blue first, if you're using a butterfly, just use a red as a waste to get the flow, because I still do that to this day. If I have to leave out here and go draw blood and they want a blue top tube and that's all they need, believe me, I'm pulling a red top first. Yes, half fill, or not even half fill, right below that label maybe, and then I'm gonna trash it because I'm gonna get the flow that I need. There's no right or wrong with the blue first or the red first, because remember, there's nothing in the red that's going to affect your blue. That's why you hear the difference sometimes, blue or red, and it can be confusing. So just stay on board, stay in your lane, wherever you're working, whatever they say do, that's what you do. So blue, I say B for blue. B, what? Just be you. First of all, because a patient wants an authentic patient walking into their room. Be present. Be in the now. That's what my B is for. B-E. Blue. B. Ready is for red. Be ready. Now you got your persona right. You got your mojo going. Get your things together. Be ready. Don't go in the room fumbling, looking for things, all discombobulated, because your patient is going to peek that and they're going to think you're incompetent and they're not going to want you to draw their blood. They're going to think you're incompetent or you're just lazy or you're just not together. Nobody wants to see that. So be ready when you walk into your patient room. Now that's in the hospital. If you're in a clinic, excuse me, you may have to go and get the patient from the waiting area. So that is why I say be ready, go. Even if you're in the hospital, go upstairs, go downstairs. Now it's time to go. It's time to go get them. Be ready, go. Go positively to get your patient. Once you get them, you gotta greet them. That's where green comes in. Be ready, go, greet. Greet them. Smile. Yes. Miss Green, how you doing? Oh, that's a cute dress, girl. We're gonna get your blood today. My name is Crystal. Have a seat, whatever. That's clinic. I've done both, so I have to do the clinic. I just called my patient back and got him in my chair. Now, if I'm walking in a room, same thing. Oh my gosh, Miss Green, how are you? Oh my gosh. My name is Crystal. Hate to see you under these circumstances, but I do have to get your blood today. Lighten it up. Greet them. That's a greeting. That's a greeting. I had a phlebotomist come to me one day, 3-4 years ago, honey. I was in the hospital. She didn't open her mouth. And I thought, yeah, you know where that's going. We'll do a video on that. So don't be that guy. Be ready. Oops. Go. Greet. And laugh. Lighten things up. So lavender is for laugh. You're going to be ready. You're going to go. Greet your patient and you're gonna laugh. Make them laugh. Make your patients laugh, or you just smile. Same thing. Let's just laugh a little. Miss Johnson, this is gonna hurt me more than it's gonna hurt you, but I gotta do it. You know? So let me look over here. Let me look over there. And you know, even if you do that, a patient is relaxed. Even if you say that, it just lightens the mood. If even somebody just laying there looking stupid, they're gonna smile at you, because I've had it done to me. They're looking real crazy, like, oh, here we go again. And when I see that look on their face, I lighten things up with a little laughter. I'm like, you know what, Miss Green, this is gonna hurt me more than it hurts you. I know how you're feeling, because I'm drawing PTs on you. They're drawing PTs on you, what, 3-4 times a day? you're on this Coumadin or this heparin, that's why. But I'm going to go ahead and get it. And, you know, at least you'll have a 3-hour break. They won't be back for another 3-4 hours or whatever. Talk to your patient. If you know that information, talk to them and let them know. Because a lot of patients are clueless sometimes because they've been rushed into the rooms. The nurses leave. You know, the doctor hasn't come yet. Sometimes they don't even know why we're sticking them. So sometimes it's okay for you to say, oh, and we already know from the previous video, PT, INR, PTT is a blood thinner, and most times there's a drip hanging. You can look, oh, you're on heparin. That's why they're drawing this so much. So they're going to be drawing this. What have they been coming, what, every 3 hours, 4 hours? Yeah, they'll do that because you're on this heparin and you have to have it drawn that often. So I'm sorry, but I'm going to get it now, and, you know, they'll be back. Or just talk to your doctor when they come in and see how much longer this is going to be. Be nice to your patients. Talk to them. Even that right there will prompt the conversation for a little bit of laughter, which you can throw in there just to make their day. So yes, I rambled. I digress. But be ready. Go greet. Laugh. The last tube that I threw in here for an order of draw was gray. For great, because be great. If you do all those things, see how I conversated, that customer service I threw in there, that's you being great. Be ready, go greet, laugh, and be great. Be great at it. Because if you do these things, you're gonna be great. You're gonna be that phlebotomist where you get it every time, your patient is comfortable, and they don't mind you having to stick them a second time if you have to. And just be honest with your patients. Oops, I missed. Miss Green, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Now look, we have options. You have options. You can let me try again, or I can leave and someone else can come back. But they're going to come right back. They'll be back in a few minutes. All that good stuff. That's your order of draw. That's what you want to happen. You want to give that customer service during the order of draw, which is why I came up with the mnemonic that I did, because I think it relays customer service, just lightness. It helps you. It helps your patient. And 9 times out of 10, if you follow that, you get your blood. I promise you that. Practice it and see, but practice with a straight needle. And we'll talk about that in another video. So thumbs up, share, like. Let me know what you think about this video. Let me know what you think in general. For those of you who are seeing this for the first time, just let me know. Comment, please, down below. Keep those comments coming, what you want to see, what you like, all that good stuff. And I promise you, I'm getting it up. Yes, I'm on a roll. So this week is the week, or leading into next week, and we'll have a class or two this week. So make sure your notification bell is turned on for that too. So double check it, and I will see you guys in the next video. I'll see y'all later. Bye.